Good morning, church family. Welcome to our morning virtual worship. We'll be giving a word from our pastor, Dr. Richard L. Hall, Sr., followed by Sunday school lesson and church announcements. Have a good day.
At the end of the day, the favor of God can open the way.
God's favor is more precious than life.
God's favor more precious.
Sunday morning worship. God bless you and thank you for tuning in this morning. Gracious and eternal God, we thank you now for the safekeeping and the sparing of our lives. We pray now that you would open our understanding and that you would feed us with wisdom. Feed us that we might be able to walk with thee. In Jesus' name, amen. There's a passage of scripture in the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 11, and we call your focus and your attention to verse number 7. We'll be reading from the New King James Version. Hebrews 11 and 7. By faith, Noah, being divinely warned of things not yet seen, moved with godly fear, prepared an ark for the saving of his household, by which he condemned the world, and became heir of the righteousness which is according to faith. There's a series of illustrations of the heroes of faith of the Old Testament. And they began with the phrase, by faith. So this morning, for a little while, we just want to talk about by faith. By faith. Noah is one of the great heroes, or the faith heroes, of the Old Testament. In the book of Genesis, chapter 6 and verse 11, God declared that the earth also was corrupt before God. And the earth was filled with violence. My brothers and my sisters, we are well aware of the destruction and the damage that violence does. The Lord declared that the earth was filled with violence. My brothers and sisters, in the absence of well-managed government, it is easy to imagine what evils will come to light. Men do what is right in their own eyes, because they have no fear of God and no respect for the laws of the land. When men don't fear God, the earth becomes filled with violence and injustice towards mankind. My brothers and sisters, this morning, when wickedness is on the throne, destruction and death are not far behind. Just as God used Noah, He wants to use us. However, it is not our job to warn people of a flood coming that will cover the earth. But we have to deal with a pandemic that has covered the earth. Just as safety from the flood was found in the ark, so is salvation and protection from this pandemic is found in the Lord Jesus Christ. God looked down with an eye of favor upon those who honestly, wholeheartedly, earnestly, and seriously look up to Him with an eye of faith. When God was displeased with the rest of the world, Noah found favor. God is pleased with those who are good in bad times. Noah was an exception to the rule. The earth was filled with violence. The earth was filled with ungodliness. But God is pleased with those who manage to be good in bad times. So this morning, a strong faith is needed for the times in which we are living. Faith, practically, means we cannot see the outcome. We are not sure what lies ahead. But we are convinced about the existence of God. We may not know what tomorrow may bring. We don't know what the outcome of the next week might be. But one thing we know that there is a God who rules and controls the universe. Hebrews 11 and 6, the New King James passage, says, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. It's impossible to please God without faith. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, that He's a rewarder of those who diligently, who steadily seek Him. In other words, we are not sure what the future holds. But we know who holds the future. The writer of Hebrew gives us some examples of heroes of faith. The succession of heroes of faith begins with three heroes from before the flood. These were three heroes from before the flood. Noah's faith this morning is on display in our text, in the text. Noah's faith is being illustrated. And we can learn a few things from Noah. We can learn a few things from Noah that will help us to have a little closer walk with God. First thing that we can learn from the life of Noah is by faith, Noah responds to the revelation from God. Let me say that again. By faith, Noah responds to a revelation from God. By faith, Noah responds to the word of God. Faith believes God and his word. The words being warned of God are applied to Noah in the text. Noah was warned of God. Being warned, my brothers and sisters, implies a divine communication. Notice in Matthew, you Bible scholars, Matthew chapter 2 and verse number 12, you remember when the wise men went to seek the baby Jesus. In Matthew 2 and 12, the Bible says the wise men, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way. Another way. They were divinely communicated to not to go back to Herod, but they returned to their own country another way. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. God told Noah of his intentions to judge the world for its sinfulness. And God had given Noah clear-cut instructions to build an ark to survive the flood. My brothers and my sisters, this morning, Jesus is our ark of safety to survive the flood of COVID-19. Let me ask you this morning, how do you respond to the word of God? Do you respond in obedience, or do you respond in disobedience? How you respond to the word of God determines how close a walk you can have with God. The second thing that Noah can teach us is that Noah's faith was not only in the message that God spoke, but it was in the God who spoke the message. His faith was not only in the message that God spoke. Our faith must be founded. Our faith must be based on the God who makes the promise. And so Noah's faith was not only in the message that God spoke, not only in the warning that God gave, but his faith was in the God who spoke the message, the God who gave the warning. The Bible declares that God warned of things not yet seen. God warned of things not yet seen. God told Noah as it was going to be. Noah's faith recognized that God could bring to pass whatever he said. That God could bring to pass whatever he said. God can make happen whatever he said. And up to this point, God warned him of things not yet seen. And up to this point in human history, there had been no rain. There had been no rain. Noah had not seen any rain. Noah had never heard or seen of rain before. But Noah believed God. He believed God for something that was not yet seen. How many of us this morning are willing to believe God for something we have not yet seen? Noah believed God. By faith, Noah moved with a respectful attitude, an attitude of reverence. The word move with fear carries the meaning that Noah moved carefully with reverence and with godly fear. My brothers and my sisters, let me ask you this morning, do you believe seeing is believing? Or do you believe believing is seeing? And that's what Noah did. Noah had never seen any rain, but Noah believed that he would see some rain. Noah's faith was not only in the message that God spoke, but in the God who spoke the message. Thirdly, we can learn from Noah. By faith, Noah moved into action. By faith, Noah moved into action. Noah had an active faith. It was a faith that did something. Too many of us just have faith and we don't ever act on our faith. Too many of us have faith and we just believe and we have no action to back up our belief. We don't demonstrate that we really believe. Noah responded to God's message in obedient action. Obedient action. Noah had a faith that worked. James reminds us in 2 and 14 of James. What does it profit, my brethren, if someone says that he has faith but does not have works? Can faith save him? And number 17, verse number 17 in that second chapter, it says, thus also faith by itself, if it does not have works, if it does not have any action, faith by itself is dead. No life in that kind of faith. The faith of Noah had on work clothes. Noah was moved into action. He moved with faith into action to build the ark. Noah's faith had on work clothes. Noah was a man of action. And true faith, always trust and obey. The songwriter says, trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. And so, my brothers and sisters, there's so much we can do by faith. And so this morning, as we get ready to leave you, finally, by faith, Noah withstood ridicule. By faith, Noah withstood ridicule. Is your faith strong enough to withstand being mocked, being made fun of? Is your faith strong enough to declare something is going to happen that you have not yet seen? By faith, Noah withstood the ridicule of his homeboys, withstood the ridicule of some of his family members, withstood the ridicule of the community. And we can imagine how Noah must have been made fun of, a tease, because nobody had ever seen any rain before. We can imagine that he was laughed at. He was mocked, and he was the target of all of the rumors in the neighborhood, because nobody had seen rain before. When he told his neighbors he was building an ark because it was going to rain, the rest of the world went on with its pleasures and its usual attitude. They went on with this, but their banquets, went on with their parties and the celebrations and their other activities. And so it is, my brothers and my sisters, that Jesus warns us. In Matthew 24 and 37, Jesus says, "But as the days of Noah were, so also would be the coming of the Son of Man. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until that day that Noah entered into the ark. And they did not know until the flood came and took them all away. And so also, my brothers and my sisters, are going to be the coming of the Son of Man." And a whole lot of us are going to be partying and having a good time. A whole lot of us are going to be grilling and grinning and drinking and partying. And then all of a sudden, the Son of God is coming back. But by faith, Noah withstood the ridicule. Noah chose to believe God regardless of the popular opinion. He chose to believe God regardless of peer pressure and regardless of his own feelings. I'm pretty sure that Noah had some thoughts, because he had never seen rain before. But he believed God over popular opinion, over feelings, and regardless of never having seen rain. Noah was saved by faith in God. Well, Peter says in 2 Peter chapter 2 and verse 5, God did not spare the ancient world, but saved Noah, one of eight people, a preacher of righteousness, and bringing in the flood on the world of the ungodly. Well, my brothers and my sisters, only eight people were saved. And this is typical of the fact that in a corrupt and evil society, world believers, in a society well, there's a world of unbelievers, it is typical that to understand that there's just a few that's going to be saved. The Bible says broad is the road that leads to destruction, but narrow is the way that leads to eternal life. My brothers and my sisters, by faith, we can find salvation and safety from the destruction that awaits this present world. We are when we are obedient to God, we can be assured of His blessings in our lives. Yes, a strong faith is needed for the times in which we are living. Faith means that we cannot see the outcome. We are not sure what lies ahead, but we know who holds the future. And so, my brothers and my sisters, by faith, Noah responds to the revelation from God. And Noah's faith was not only in the message of God, not only in the message that God spoke, but in the God who spoke the message. By faith, Noah moved into action. By faith, Noah withstood the ridicule. My brothers and my sisters, let me remind you this morning that we have a greater ark of safety, and that ark is the Lord Jesus Christ. The ark is a symbol of the Lord Jesus. And just as God invited Noah to come into the ark, this morning Jesus invites us to come unto Him. Come unto Him. He said, if you will come unto Him, He will in no wise cast you away. If you will come to Jesus this morning, He will in no wise turn you away. We can be saved this morning. Romans 10 and 9 says, and if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. 10 and 13 says, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. You can be saved this morning. You can be saved. Thank you, Second Honor family, and all of you that have allowed us to come into your home this morning. We do trust and pray that you feel a little better, that your faith has been made a little stronger by the Word of God. We would like to ask you to pray for the Perkins family in the passing of Brother Johnny Perkins' grandmother. We ask that you pray that family's strength in the Lord. A mighty, mighty blessing. I thank the Lord allowed her to live to be 95 years old. Tremendous blessing. Also, we ask that you will pray for Deacon Frazier. Deacon Frazier's in the hospital. Let us pray much for him. Pray his strength in the Lord. Pray that God will deliver him in this hour of sickness. Let me personally thank you so much, church family. You're simply amazing. Thank you so much for the tithes, for the billing funds, and for the missionary offerings. There's a great need in this hour for the missionary offerings. We thank you because we were able to bless our seniors for Christmas because of your contributions to the missionary offering. And we are receiving requests weekly for food. We know what time it is. And we know how we are living. And so let us continue to get those missionary offerings in. They're serving a great purpose. The Bible says, those who lendeth unto the poor, the Lord will pay you back. So you can't lose. God says, Jesus said, the poor we will have always. So let us do what we do as believers in Christ. Let's put our faith into action. We're ready to go into our new building when God says so. When God says so. But we need to continue our building fund. Keep our building fund coming. God has blessed us and you are doing a tremendous job. So we just want to personally thank you. By faith, we can keep these ministries strong. By faith. So as we leave you this morning, we ask you and we encourage you to move by faith. Faith without works is a dead faith. So let us have a living faith and let us move by faith. Well, thank you so much once again for tuning in. Let me encourage us to be safe, to be careful, to wash our hands, to keep our distance, to wear our mask, and to trust God to keep us by faith. Well, it's that time again. It's that time again. Well, until the next time, see you.
It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Good morning. In this morning's lesson, called as the intercessor, John chapter 17, verses 14 through 24, we are exploring Jesus' intercessory prayer for his disciples, in which John 17:20 says, I am praying not only for these disciples, but also for all who will ever believe in me through their message. Therefore, Jesus wants us to get ready for service. And there are 5 points or areas to give insight. Number one, overall protection from the world and the evil one. Truly, we don't belong to the world. And because we are sanctified or set apart, the world does not like that. Number two, he wants us to be equipped with the truth through the word. He asks God that we be made holy through the knowledge of his word, which is concentrating truth. Number three, sacrifice for the mission. Jesus sacrificed himself for us so that the mission can go on, the mission of spreading the gospel. However, if our Wi-Fi is weak and we can't connect to the router, we are simply defenseless and unequipped. Simply put, if our lights go out in the middle of a storm, Wi-Fi means word in, faith increased. The more word you put in, the more faith will be increased. And the router is God and Jesus. Of course, the Holy Spirit as well. In this scriptural context, we are only aware of God and Jesus. Don't let problems in and around you mess with your connection. Those things that pop up in the middle of the day, or those thoughts that happen to have you have doubt, don't let them mess with your connection to the router so that you can continue the mission. Number four, unity. He wants us to be one, a united front, just as Jesus and God are one. Therefore, we can be a witness to the world, evidence, concentrated evidence for them to believe in God. The goal is one heart and mind with Jesus and God for unity. Number five, Jesus' entourage in heaven. Jesus wants us to be right there with him, right up front and center, to see all the glory and the splendor God gave to Jesus. The love that God had for him before the world began. Also, a request for companionship and ultimately to restore the relationship between God and us for perfect unity. Isn't that wonderful? Overall, Jesus wants us to be one in unity. He asks for us to be his companion in heaven, be part of that entourage, and check your connection with God. Don't be a weak Wi-Fi, and be ready to serve. Have a great day.
Second Arnold extends heartfelt condolences to Sister Sadie and Minister Johnny Perkins in the passing of their loved one. It takes a special kind of person to care enough to take the time for others to do whatever it takes to help somebody out. To our blessed church and families, for everything you have done, for everything you have given, thank you. We thank you, God, for all you do for us and keeping all of us safe. Love, Sister Barbara Gore. Thank you. Thanks for the holiday gifts and the many calls to Pastor Hall and the entire church family. Don't know what we'd do without you. Hope you know how much you're appreciated, Mother Wiggins and family.
Welcome to our second segment of the 2021 school year for the Race Journal. As a reminder, all members are invited to submit awards, certificates, and documents highlighting their achievements via the Google link. Today's segment is dedicated to our virtual learners and college attendees. As a reminder, be encouraged and know that with God, all things are possible. Our first honoree is Brother Christian Stahill, who made the high honor roll at Coastal Middle School. Congratulations to Sister Brazen Engel, who made the Dean's List at Valdosta State University. Congrats are in order for Brother Moses Alexander McNeil, who conferred a Bachelor's of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies with a concentration of middle school grades from Savannah State University. Congratulations to Sister Pamela Williams, who is celebrating a milestone of 35 years of employment with the Savannah-Chatham County Police Department. Sister Nashe Brooks, an high honor roll IB student at Windsor Forest High School, has been accepted to Valdosta State University as well as Georgia Southern University. Once again, Sister Amani Jones has made high honor roll. Sister Amani is an IB student at Johnson High School, holding a 4.0 grade point average. Sister Gabrielle Jones is a dual enrollment student at Johnson High School and is also studying biology at Savannah Technical College. Sister Gabrielle is also a member of the volleyball team and has officially completed high school. Gabby has been accepted to Albany State, Shaw University, Benedict College, University of Georgia, and Georgia Southern with aspirations of majoring in criminal justice and becoming a private investigator. Sister Jocelyn Jones is a dual enrollment senior at Savannah Early College, where she is also studying education at Savannah State University. Sister Jones is a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, the Beta Club, and Top Teens of America. She recently participated in the Memorial Health Explorers program and maintains part-time employment. Joss has also been accepted to the University of Alabama, Georgia Southern, Kennesaw State, Albany State, Georgia State, and the University of West Georgia.
As Pastor Hezekiah Walker would say, because God is the
thanks to the Race Journal recipients. As a reminder, the journal is for all members, not just students, but anyone who would like to share an achievement or recognition. As for students, thank you for your dedication and hard work. This has been a challenging process, but keep praying and keep working. Hang in there. You got this.
Join us on Tuesday for Bible study. We will be streaming all services on our YouTube channel, the church's website, as well as on Facebook. A link will also be provided each week. Also, join us on the prayer line at 7 p.m. on Wednesdays. Dial 1-605-313-5086. The access code is 796275#.
Harvest Day 2020 begins today. Harvest Day contributions, tithes and offering, as well as all building fund donations, can be contributed through the GiveLify app in person from 12:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. or by mail.
Pastor Hezekiah Walker would say,
oh, thank you, Lord.
Because God is the greatest power.